much on message. Not the best of breaks there, though.
There's two ways to execute a cut break. Generally speaking, that's a three-quarter ball hit medium hard with body action, or cutting it a little more, spinning the cue ball, just like Mika Immonen did. It's more like a soft medium, medium hit. And I think the latter is harder to execute consistently. He has a shot on the one, and he has Efren as an opponent. Does he want to get involved into a safety battle? He did win the last one. Makes a world of difference how close you position that cue ball behind the blocking ball. I don't think Efren has a route in between the rail and the four ball. He's masseying into the rail. What a shot! Great shot. Actually, I must say, it is a great shot, but the rail, in this case, helps. It makes it easier for that cue ball to hook towards that one ball.
Well, they call him the magician, and we've just seen one of his tricks.
Looking at a containing safety, at least the object ball safe, and maybe the bonus. A two-row escape over the right side of the table for Efren. He's favorite to hit the one ball, but of course he would like to play a resave to make something happen here. Travel towards the four.
Wow.
What a shot by Efren. He chose a more difficult path, one rail, but with a bigger probability of getting lucky. That's what he always says. I got lucky, but the more I practice, the luckier I get.
Nearly. But the cue ball, jarring in the jaws of that top pocket, has really helped Efren Reyes. Really helped. His tactical mastery and ability to see a shot that no one else can, I think, is unparalleled. There, though, fortune helped.
Beautiful. You can't beat that. A big miss there by Mika. It was not an easy shot. You'd expect him to make it.
Yes, especially after the momentum gain from that one. And so Reyes should have the simplest of propositions to run out and make it 2-1. We were talking about the World Cup of Pool right at the start of this match, of course, Alex. Efren Reyes and Francisco Bustamante won the inaugural World Cup of Pool, and their popularity in their native Philippines knows no bounds. Put the shoulder into that, not exactly technically textbook, but it worked.
It's not a jury sport.
It sure isn't, but there, Efren Reyes found guilty of pulling Iraq back. He trails 2-1.
Well, we can see now, it's turned to Reyes' return.
Well, return, there's a return. This time, it seems not a return, but a return, everyone is a return. One, two, and then the 3rd return, just in front of the mother return. That's good.
哇，进了好像三个球啊！我们看到六号球进了，二号球进了，
对，一号球进中袋啊，这个就是这个一号球进中袋啊，就是他们这些选手啊，这个选择了这个袅袅冲的一个最大的原因啊，这个因为由于这个一号球啊比较靠近球台的中央，所以说呢啊进中袋就更容易了啊，比原来的原点要进中袋就更容易了。
好，四号球，
哎，拉杆啊，这个拉杆走了这个三颗星上去啊。好，这个球以这个五号球的角度来看的话，必须在拉杆啊，左塞拉杆两颗星走到七号球的左边啊。好，拉杆两颗星弹上来。好，继续再拉杆回去。颗星弹出来，哎，哇，角度做那么大，哇，会不会有什么意外？好，这个球可能必须要走两，母球可能要走两颗星了啊，这不管打哪个带都要走，可能都要走两颗星了。用推杆的方式，好，看他下左塞啊，下左塞推杆。好，没问题啊！下左塞推杆走了三颗星，弹了下来，再多走一点点。好，保左下角底带，好，看看有没有什么特殊的打法。好，球杆还够得到啊，所以说不需要特殊的打法。我们在过去曾经看到他把这个球杆放。
接花式撞球大师赛这场八强的比赛。
Rack six from race to break.Leading 3-2.
Last break of Efren, he made 2 balls, but no third ball crossed the line. He needs to add some speed. Okay, this is a legal break. And a perfect shot on a one. This should be a rack point for Efren. Could be a good rack for him to gain momentum, to pick up some rhythm.
He's playing in England for the first time since 2006. And right now, a marginal favourite, you would say, to make a winning return. He's never won this World Masters title, one of the few big events missing from his CV. But compatriots...do have their names on the trophy. Francisco Bustamante in 1998 and again in 2001. And Dennis Okolo in Las Vegas in 2010. You can't keep a champion down.
You do.
I'll bet your breakfast the six goes.
Here we go. The six is the wing ball. It's on the left-hand side.
I'll tell you what, I'll lay you 2 breakfasts to 1. No, I'll tell you, that's about the percentage. It's been going 8 out of 10 times. and maybe the one in the side also. Oh, he made the one in the side anyway. The six missed by a hair, but I was wrong. But look at the way they stopped.
Okay, very quickly, you can see that the three is in the open near the lower right-hand corner. The four is up table adjacent to the cue ball. The five ball is to the right of the foot spot. The six is near the left-hand rail, near the side pocket. The seven is underneath the black eight. So from the six to the seven is a little bit of a problem. And also from the five to the six. So therefore, he's going to have to come up with a good angle on the five. Now he's looking to see if the five will pass the seven, because that's the pocket he would like to play position for the five.
Yeah.
If he plays position for that corner pocket, then he can go around the table freely without having to go into the possible interfering seven ball. So therefore, he's going to play position for the five in the lower left-hand corner.
And actually, once he moves the five, falling on the seven is an easier shot, because he doesn't have that to contend with.
But he's got to come up with a pretty good shot on the six that carries a good angle to drop nicely for the seven.
Right.
So therefore, he has some work in this rack.
Yeah.
But that's what he gets paid for.
And he's been getting paid pretty well lately. He is one of the most successful pool players ever, financially.
Okay, now this is kind of interesting. He's rather flat on the five. He's going to end up shooting the six in the upper left-hand corner, but he must come up with an angle. Now he's going underneath it with the cue ball, which indicates, or at least tells me, that no, he's not going to play position for the six in the upper left-hand corner. He's looking to play position for the six in the lower left-hand corner. That could be a problem. He's really not comfortable with this, Danny.
No, he got funny. He'd be all right here if he could make this and sit right on that side rail. He'll have an angle to get to the seven, if he goes that way, which he did. See, now he's fine.
Now, that's right where I thought he should have gone to begin with. Yeah. He wasn't really comfortable with that. Yeah. So he took a look at the other possibility and ended up shooting this one here, which I feel he made the correct decision, particularly now the way he laid on the six. Very nicely executed, nicely run out. It was a nice run out on this particular rack.
Right.
Very nicely run.
Yeah, there's not any problem here. And Mika could start thinking about last rack when he missed. You know, it's all you have to do with someone like Efren is make one mistake and you're way in the hole.
Particularly after he pocketed the one in the side, because that ball he's playing. So therefore, if he has the good feel pocketing the one on the side, Mika may not have too many appearances at the table, considering that if Reyes is pocketing the one on the side, he's going to have that opportunity that he wants to run the balls. That's rack number two. It also goes Efren's way.
Barracks. Jamie Barracks. And the reason I didn't know the name that well is he's a new player. I never heard of him, really, but he's in the final four. So that's the winner of that table plays the winner of this table.
Keep in mind, this is a very short race to seven, and the difference in playability is actually the difference in the quality of play between these two players is very little when you're playing nine ball, particularly in a short race to seven. Now Reyes is considered the best player in the world today, but Mika Immonen isn't far behind.
Well, he was ranked number one particular year. But here, the big thing about this short race is balls go on to break on this table. And when you break from the left side, the left corner ball goes in this left pocket and vice versa. So I expect them, whoever breaks is going to have a chance to run out.
Well, it was really important for Mika to jump out of the gate quickly. He had a good opportunity in rack number one, as you just saw, but was unable to put down the 1-5 combination. Now, Reyes steps to the table. All balls are in the open. And Danny, you know as well as anyone, when all balls are in the open and Mr. Reyes is at the table, he takes care of business.
Yeah, you should have the rack in your hand ready to play the next game, especially the way they're sitting. You know, this is pretty easy layout. He's got, if you want to cause a trouble spot, it's right now. The one to the two might be the only chance to go astray, and that's easy.
He followed the cue ball, two cushions out of the corner for position for the two. The three balls positioned on the same rail as the two. Therefore, he may have to end up taking a little longer shot on the three than he wanted to, but shouldn't present much of a problem. Now keep in mind, these are very small pockets. Now, the angle that he's going to be shooting this three from is a difficult angle, so he has to hit this shot cleanly.
Yeah, this looks like the only problem, and I figure him to make this.
Notice he took a little extra time in preparation and shooting that shot. Now, that shot's over, and I'm certainly sure he's glad that's over, because that was the tough shot in this rack.
Yeah. I see no problems here, especially Efren Reyes. Sometimes, look at this. Man, he hit that a little fuller. He could have been snookered. But then he would have kicked it in some way anyway.
Now, he has a little bit of a problem, because he's laying rather awkwardly on the six. He may have to go around the nine, because trying to control the cue ball where the six is right now may be a problem. That's what he's going to do. He's going around the nine, traveling a little extra with the cue ball, but a fair trade-off, has a better shot on the eight.
Yeah, he's sitting pretty good here. Just have to make the ball and draw back a little. Shoot the spot shot. Well, he went forward. He had a little angle. He wanted to get close as he can to the nine, which you always try to do.
First shot on the nine in this match isn't really considered an easy one, but he should handle it.
Well, Efren takes 1-0 lead. I'm curious to see where he...
...profit, and this also works as a booster of confidence. If you know that you have figured out the break and the speed and that you will be getting shots, that gives a lot of confidence. Add to that Efren Reyes not getting position on the first shot after the break a couple of times. The 4 and 7, good place to hide behind. Doesn't need to attack from here.
And the 8 comes into the equation also.
He did it. I think he did it.
Well, from Immonen's body language and that of Reyes, I don't think the snooker is there. I think Immonen can get through to the two ball. Just thinking, you know, as Reyes went back to his chair there, it's impossible to calculate how many racks of pool he must have played in his life. He must have come across virtually every eventuality and played in some extraordinary venues, both in tournaments and for hard cash. What a story he could tell. And after that, he might be playing for a while longer here in Barnsley. The three will pot. It's tough, but it goes.
Intricate choice of shot by Immonen. He had a straight shot on the two, could have played a draw shot to leave himself straight on the three, which seemed to pass the nine ball. Never threaten to the pocket, Efren Reyes. And that is the harsh part, that with age, his B game is weakening. But now and then, once and again, he can still bring his A game. So it's very tough for him, I suspect, to accept the lack of consistency.
Yes, Reyes falling victim to exactly the same thing that snooker players find themselves falling victim to as they get older, even the very best. their putting from distance and also their ability to concentrate for sustained periods declines. People assume that pool players and aging snooker players aren't so successful as the years go by because of deteriorating eyesight. It is a factor, but I think more important, the ability or the lack of ability to concentrate and the fact that the pots go astray. Plus, of course, you pick up more and more mental scar tissue.
So here we have it. Efren now needing a lot of action on the cue ball over distance. He cannot play it with topspin. It will kill the cue ball there. Oh, did he make that look easy? He cheated the pocket there, pocketing the three ball in the side of the pocket, thereby creating an angle and enabling him to hit it with stun draw and a lot of left hand side.
All of those hours and hours of playing as a youngster, a teenager, then in his prime, and now when he's regarded as a grand old master of the game. And regardless of the result here, it's great to see him back on British shores.
Using his stroke not to force the angle, but to control the angle. Top players leave angles. They try to avoid the position like this. Immonen had a shot for the match. It was that long cut on the three ball, which he mishit. So after all the mistakes, it will be 7-6.
That's right, and make no mistake.
我们看到这个 9号球是排在这个foot spot啊，也就是这个腿点啊。那一号球就蛮靠近这个球台的中央啊，这是一个这个在过去从来没有尝试过的一个排球法。所以说我们看到这个米卡伊缪尼冲球冲得很轻啊，还是维持他在这个世界杯的一个冲球的方法，但是这一次是大失所望，没有球进。 而且一号球呢就放了像在右上角的底带。好，再看一次啊，我们仔细看这个九号球啊，刚刚好在这个我们平常三角框的尖端啊，所以说一号球已经跑到了这靠近球台的中央了。这比赛是采取抢七局制啊。好，那么现在二号球啊，可能要来一个中杆推杆啊，推一点点啊，推个差不多5公分左右，来做这个三号球的中带。 好，我们看啊，一个中杆推杆啊，母球刚刚好往前走了5公分啊，相当的漂亮。那么为什么要往前走5公分呢？啊，这样子的话做三号球，打三号球才可以很顺利的来做到四号球啊。好，我们看它往前推啊，往前推的话呢，大概就是要推下来了啊，推到台边啊来做5号球。好，推到台边下来啊，弹一点点上来。 好，那么6号球当然是来做另外一边的底带。好，6号球做了一个大角度的球啊，这样子的话，好，这个薄球啊，看看是走1颗星或者2颗星啊，这个7号球做上方的底带。 啊，我们看拉杆走了2颗星啊，当然这个走1颗星或者2颗星啊，这个完全要靠你刹车的这个能耐啊来决定啊。如果说你认为说这个球太薄了啊，这个直接走1颗星刹不了车，那你就必须要走2颗星了。 好，横台啊，力道控制的非常好啊，做到了九号球。所以我们看到这个 A-Frame 打球啊，这个速度非常的流畅啊。当然啦，这个一方面当然也是信心的问题啊，一方面也就是这个对这个整个啊这个环 Reyes
seconds here and I have watched a few and it's the corner I say the eight goes in the right hand corner pocket straight in
notice the one on the side
right.
That's the ball
both of those been going
but that's the ball he's going to get paid off for the one on the side fortunately for Immonen the two ball found a position but behind the orange five not allowing Reyes at the table with an offensive shot he has to look elsewhere
I think he's going to try to fan the two and put him behind the nine. He's got a good safe there, and he's got such good cue ball control.
That's
what he's doing.
Excellent observation, and yeah. You hit it right on the head when you said yeah. He's got great cue ball control.
And I've been talking for days about when you're going to snooker a guy, it's way bigger if you freeze the guy on the ball you're snookering him with because it takes away a whole bunch of kicks.
Now, that's the strength of being able to pocket balls on the break. And I said a little earlier that if he's pocketing the one on the side with regularity, then he has control of the table. When you give Efren Reyes control of the table, it doesn't much matter if the ball's laying well or not. He's going to figure out a way to win the game.
You know what he's got here, Billy? I don't know if he knows it himself. He's got that trick shot where you shoot into the rail and hop over the nine. You see it, the side rail? I don't know if he's going to hit it anyway. You know the shot I'm talking about?
Oh, you mean he's going to elevate, hit the
elevate
side rail?
Elevate a little, hit the side rail, goes right over the nine, and you got a chance to make the two.
Well, you know, you're a very, very creative man, and a very creative player. And the more I look at the situation, the more I have the tendency to agree with that.
Yeah.
If he elevates over the nine, shooting the cue ball into the right side rail, the cue ball will then jump over the nine and hit the two. A very, very low percentage shot, but he may not have anything else.
No, it's a low percentage, but it's going to be lower percentage to do anything other than that and hit the two. And you know, in this spot, if he had any possibilities at all, when I say there's an impossible kick or near impossible kick, tie up balls if you can, but he's not in that position.
Well, unfortunately, Reyes has actually frozen the cue ball solidly against the nine, actually precluding him from tying up any balls because the only two balls that he can see are the nine and the three. And I don't believe he can tie up either one of those two. So therefore, he has to do something. Now, look, he's going to shoot your shot.
Well, I hope so because he's supposed to know the shot.
You've
got to have it in your repertoire. You know, for this particular situation, well, if he elevates too much.
No, what he wants to do, he wants to hit the rail and bend it.
He's elevating too much.
No, he wants to hit the rail and bend it, Danny.
He's going to go past it. He's mad
right.
saying
he's
it.
Bending.
I see.
See, he's bending it.
Yeah.
So therefore, he didn't recognize the shot that you did.
No, he did
have a legitimate shot at bending it, but he wasn't able to do it. Reyes now has ball in hand. Balls are open once again. Three ball near the lower right-hand corner, four ball adjacent from the side pocket, five ball in the open in the center, near the center of the table, six near the side pocket, seven, nine. Shouldn't be any problems for Reyes.
You see how close he got to the three? When you're playing out there, trying to get close when you can get a chance to do that. You know, you could be a foot more away, but if you got a chance to get close, do it. If it's not affecting pocketing.
Now he's going to go around table again here. One, two, three cushions. He's going to get close to the five, and he's going to go toward the five in line. That's why he played position like that.
He's got to draw it back a few feet and get straight in. No, he don't have to. He's just stopping shooting it in the corner. Yeah, don't do more work than you have to.
Well, particularly if you feel good about your ball pocketing.
Yeah.
You know, if you can pocket balls, you're comfortable with your ability to pocket balls, then you play position for the corner more often. And I feel that if once you do that, I think that your runout percentage goes way up because when you move the cue ball.
And you know, over the years, we've seen Efren play real well.
Right.
Right? But when he gets in this kind of gear, it looks like he's never going to miss. I'm sorry, I cut in on you. Go ahead.
这个年年的这个波兰这个 Warpul League 对都是陪榜的，但是这一年呢，感觉他进步很多。
对，每一位选手都会进步啊，然后高手也会老啊。
哎，一号球呢还是没有进左边的中袋，留下了一个大的chance。
哎，有球进啊！我们看进的是二号球进了啊。
对。
好，那么现在一号球，但是跟母球距离太近了啊，有没有办法进攻呢？好，从这个角度来看，看不出来啊，因为我们看不出来母球跟一号球到底的距离是多少啊。这距离是个关键啊，距离太近就没有办法进攻了。好，有一点点距离啊，但是母球有没有办法闪过中带呢？
现在要进这一号球，他觉得应该不是问题了。他现在大概是在想如何来做三号啊。
不是，这个母球会进中带啊，这个母球搞不好就进中带了。
对，小心啊，
这个有点好，看看，
好打得很薄。哎呀，这个球一号球进了。
好，那么三号球可不可以过呢？三号球如果过不去的话，那就来打一个三九组合球啊，可以过，
可以过，
啊、
对，
清楚啊，非常的清楚。待会儿看看四号球在哪里。
四号球在上方啊。现在米卡伊莫的每一球都要步步为营，非常小心啊，因为他已经没有在后退的本钱了。
好，哦，吼吼，这个球还三号球打得非常不准了，借九号球进的嘞。如果说观众刚有仔细看的话啊，三号球打得非常不准了，借九号球进带的。
而且呢，刚才呢母球撞到六号球啊，现在母球停在球台中央。做到四号球左上角底带，不过是一个大角度的薄球啊。
好，这个哇，母球必须要闪过八号球啊，看看有没有办法闪得过去。
小心。
好，拉杆。好，只好走这个路线了啊。那这样子我们看看过得去吗？
嗯，要不然可以来打一个五七的组合球啊。
对，因为刚刚为什么不推杆走到五号球的右边啊？当然最主要的原因就是因为八号球的位置有可能会挡住母球，所以说啊，他才只好来走这个路线啊，走左边的路线。好，过不去啊，就做安全球了啊，这没有办法的事情。
好，我们看现在应该还解得到啊。
对 ，Rios， 哎，可以打得到啊。问题是怎么样子来做安全球啊？这个当然，我们每次啊，每一次不管是看 AFN 的这个比赛，或者是说跟他比赛啊，每一次都可以学到一点东西啊。这个因为 AFN 他真的是一位天才型的选手啊，这个安全球的路线啊，或者是说这个其他解球的路线啊，那有时候啊都会让我们啊这个相当的惊奇。
对，很多球是他打完之后大家才想到，哦，原来可以这样打。
对，有这个路线啊。
好，我们看看他这个球直接可以解得到。
好，下低杆啊，打薄球，准备利用六号球来吊球啊，力道控制得非常好，这球好球，漂亮，一个漂亮的低杆左塞啊，低杆左塞。
嗯，看他有点很不满意啊，那
大概是太好解了、啊。
对，
好，你看啊，可以打得到一点点，虽然说没办法进攻，但是可以让对手打到，他就非常不满意了啊。
五号球呢，这个画面上现在左边的这个角度已经被六号球给挡到。
好，看看要不要来灌底带。好，还是打安全球啊！打安全球的话，哎呀，放呛死了啊！
哦哦，
放呛死了啊！这个球啊，其实米卡伊缪你可以尝试来灌底带啊。Fabio Petroni， 还有
Alex Lady， 还有 Bustamante。
好，打进绕球台出来哦，漂亮。哎，过头了啊！好，过头了，又必须来绕球台。好，那么现在这个球可以来走一个，可以走一个左塞啊，左塞中杆左塞啊，然后母球走两颗星啊，或者是三颗星啊，沿着左边啊再下来。我们看看是不是走这个路线啊？好，下左塞啊，我们看啊，沿着左边下来。 好球啊！这是一个中杆左塞的路线啊。
好球，左上角两颗星之后，现在做到了七号球。那么这场比赛呢，应该要结束了啊。
对，
要结束了，
差不多了啊。
好，现在我们看到 Reyes， 哇，对，刚刚出炉的世界冠军。这场比赛 Reyes 已经47岁了，面对28岁的年轻选手，这位 Mika Immonen 打起来呢，可以说是四平八稳啊。那我们看到这场比赛呢，
最后一个九号球，
对，打进九号球，结果他以大比分呢，而且比赛还蛮悬殊的，7-2打败了 Mika Immonen， 要追就很难了。这是两位选手第一次在世界花式撞球大师赛里面的交手。
好，我们再来欣赏一下这个鸟鸟冲啊，看看一号球会不会进中袋。好，哎，
又进了。
对，现在已经两位选手都已经有冲球的经验了啊。第一局两个人都冲不进啊，然后从这个第三局开始呢啊，当然了，这个都知道怎么去控制力量了啊，然后瞄准什么点啊，所以说这个当然一号球进中袋就变成了理所当然的事情了。
不过现在二号球呢，可能啊比较难进攻啊。那我们看看 Mika Immonen。
好，这个组合球不好打啊，为什么呢啊？因为五号球贴着台边啊，这不好打。好，果然没进啊，这是一个难打的组合球。
哇，放枪死给对方了。
对，好，那么这个现在这个组合球就非常好打了啊。
对，
这个几乎闭着眼睛就可以打得进了。
这是少林必死球。我们看到二五的组合球打进，那现在二号球继续同样一个带，三号球就在它上面。
好，那么三号球考虑一下，是要做上方底带呢，或者是说要来做同一个带啊？做同一个带的话，当然打半颗球啊，这右塞出去啊。那如果要做上方底带的话，就稍微打厚一点啊，打整颗一点。好啊，我们看到打半颗球，一颗星上去啊，做同一个带啊，这是比较。这个一般来讲，九号球选手的一个比较合理的做球方式啊。当然啊，我们过去看到很多斯诺克选手啊，碰到这个球，有可能三号球就会做上方底带。好，那么现在六号球是不是来做中带啊？看看四号球是什么角度啊？直球直接拉杆，好，直接拉杆，未来做到中带，再轻轻的推杆啊。
伊莫呢，他今天也是偶有失误啊。那刚才的那个二五的组合球没打进，结果现在
对基本上来讲，他刚刚的那个二五组合球拼的有点勉强啊，因为那个球我们刚已经讲了，是一个非常难打的组合球啊。
对，因为五号球贴着台边啊，他的切线的角度呢感觉是不合理啊，但是他刚才勉强进攻，结果付出了代价。你看现在呢 Reyes。准备要把比分拉开5-2，那这样对于Immonen来讲，他虽然贵为当年的世界冠军，但是
有时候也是要靠球运啊，有时候这个比赛也是要靠球运。
他一个比赛状态都可能不一样啊，这必须要这些个别来谈的。现在5-2，在伦敦 Lakeside Shopping Center 所进行。